everyone. In today's video, I want to share with you 5 reasons why you should think about using a 50mm lens if you like to do portrait photography. So I have the Canon 50mm 1.2 lens, and this is what I currently use when I'm doing portrait photography or wedding photography, and I want to use the 50mm focal length. So I'm using the 50mm on a full frame camera. So I have the Canon 5D Mark IV, and all the example images that you'll see throughout this video were taken on this exact lens, the 50 1.2, and on a variety of full frame bodies, such as the Canon 5D Mark IV and III and the Sony A7 III as well. In saying that, all the reasons in this video can apply to any 50mm lens that you have. It doesn't have to be the 1.2. So let's get into it. The first reason, a 50mm lens is a must in portrait photography and just to have in your kit in general, is because it's so versatile. I like to keep things simple when I'm shooting, so a 50mm is perfect to capture a wide variety of shots. You can capture close-up portraits, full-length photos, you can capture pretty much any aspect of a wedding day, from the getting ready to the bridal portraits and also guests mingling at the reception. And you can also take it with you while you're traveling as well, as it makes for a really great landscape lens. You can also capture portraits of the people that you're traveling with and photos of the buildings and stuff around you if you're in a city. Back when I first started photography and I was able to get my first professional DSLR, I only had money for one lens, so I decided to get the Nifty 50, which is the Canon 50mm 1.4. And I actually still have that lens with me today. It was such a great little lens. So this was the only lens that I had for a whole year before I was able to start adding other lenses into my kit. And I shot such a wide variety of work on this one 50mm lens, so I can definitely vouch for the fact that it's versatile. The second reason a 50mm lens is great for portrait photography is because it has little to no distortion. Because of this, it's super flattering for close-up portraits and one of my favorite things to use this lens for. Having minimal lens distortion is also great for being able to capture full-length photos of someone, especially compared to a lens such as the 35mm. Here are some comparison images to show you guys what that looks like side by side, the 50 compared to the 35. Since the 50mm is such a great lens for capturing full-length portraits, you can use it to shoot lookbook or e-commerce photos, and here are a few examples of what that looks like that I've shot both on location and in the studio as well. The third reason is that because the 50mm is a prime lens and it has a wide aperture, you can shoot with a shallow depth of field. So you guys know that I absolutely love shooting at f1.2, and aside from it giving your photos a dreamy look shooting with such a shallow depth of field, there are still a few other reasons why I like to do that. The first one is that you can get some really great background to foreground separation to help bring all the attention to your subject and help them stand out in the photo. Shooting with a wide open aperture also really helps to soften the light, especially if you're shooting in harsh or direct sunlit conditions. Lastly, it's also the perfect option to have when you have to take photos in low light conditions. This is especially handy when I'm taking photos at weddings, especially the bride and groom getting ready, which normally happens indoors. Having a wide aperture lens means that I can shoot in those low light conditions and still capture really high quality photos. A tip for when you're shooting with a shallow depth of field is to use a manual focus point and put that focus point directly on the eye that's closest to your lens. Also, be aware of how much you and your subject are moving around, as usually the slightest shift forwards or backwards can really shift the focus out at 1.2 if you've locked off your focus before you press the shutter. I definitely recommend lots of practice to get used to shooting at 1.2, but it's definitely such a beautiful aperture to shoot portraits with. Reason number 4 is its size and weight. The 50mm is one of the smaller and lighter prime lenses of Canon's range, especially if you go for something like the 1.4 or the 1.8. Here's a size comparison between the 1.2 and the 1.4. Even though weight of camera gear isn't everyone's priority, for some people it is really important. Having a lighter lens is really great when you have long days of shooting. It's also perfect for when you're capturing movement, as you can really easily move around with your model. And it's also perfect for when you're traveling, as you have something lighter to take with you on the plane, and you also don't have extremely heavy camera gear weighing you down while you're actually traveling and exploring. Last but not least, I feel like having a 50mm lens can also improve your photography. If you're looking to get your first prime lens or looking to get just your first lens in general, I personally feel that the 50mm lens is a really good investment. Aside from all the reasons that I've already mentioned in this video, I feel like a 50mm lens or using a prime lens is something that every photographer should experience and try at least once. By having a prime lens in your kit, you have to physically move around to get the right composition that you're after. Instead of just standing in one spot and zooming in and out to get the shot, I feel like a prime lens really makes you think about what you're going to capture before you press the shutter. I found that using a prime lens really helped me experiment a lot more with compositions and angles that I didn't used to do when I only had a zoom kit lens. So photographing with either zoom lenses or prime lenses does come down to personal preference and what shot you're trying to get. But as I mentioned earlier, I do highly recommend to try out using a prime lens if you have never tried it before. And I also feel like the 50mm focal length is the perfect place to start. So those are my 5 reasons why a 50mm lens is so important if you do portrait photography. Please let me know in the comments if you guys have a 50mm lens, and also let me know what you like capturing with it, as I really, really love hearing from you guys. But as always, thank you so much for watching. I upload new videos every Wednesday and Saturday, so I will see you guys all next time. Bye!